Hey guys, welcome to the next tutorial of Ethical Hacking and Penetration Testing via Kali Linux. So this is the continuation of my previous tutorial, so I'll just go ahead and give you a short brief about what happened exactly. I used SE Toolkit to create a simple payload for Midinterpreter, and I went ahead and ran that through my old computer. So I'm assuming over here that through some social engineering or other stuff, you have inserted this into your target person's computer. And once you have that in their system, it is up and running. And now, as you can see, I typed sessions hyphen L, and we have this session open. And I used session hyphen I space 1 to go ahead and get access to that. So now you might be thinking that we could do all thing or anything that we want through the command prompt. Then why would we would need a Midinterpreter? The reason being that if the person, as I told you in one of my previous tutorial, he's smart enough, he will straight away go ahead to the task manager and right click the payload that's running and end the process tree, and it will get disconnected. So the first thing that we would be doing over here is we would be migrating process to something else. So I'll just type migrate and we'll type help. And as you can see, a process ID must be specified and not a process name. So we need the process ID for our payload that's running over here. So let's go ahead and since running the Kali Linux, we don't know what is the process ID of the payload running. So just go ahead and type help and see what all things can we do by using the Midinterpreter. We can go ahead and manipulate the timestamp, which is quite an awesome feature of this one. So that the person, even if you have infiltrated some big organization and you have changed the time dates for each and everything, the forensic investigator will just be confused and he will not even be able to know what is actually happening over there. Then we have the hasdump database that will go ahead and dump all the contents of the security access manager. That is our simple computer. That means for the Windows, Windows has the SAM database, that security accounts manager or access manager something, that stores each and every password that you save in your computer. So hasdump will go ahead and spit out all the passwords that you have along with the username. Then we have get system that will go ahead and gain access to our local system. That is, we only have the administrator access as of now, but we will get the system access. That means we will be able to edit and modify the system files. Then if our computer has video webcam, then we can go ahead and gain a snapshot of that. And we can also go ahead and record our targets, audio chat and video chat, anything that we want, and all of these things. Then we can go ahead and get a screenshot, or we can go ahead and use multiple desktops if we want. We can start keystroke login, key scan, and all of these things. But these are not things we are interested. I'm teaching you that later on. The most important thing that first is that we need to secure our access into that computer. We need to go ahead and make sure that the person does not go ahead and kill our process. So for that, we would need to go ahead and migrate. And before we migrate, we need to know which PID to migrate, which process to migrate to. So let's go ahead and check. It needs a process ID name that to be specified. So we will first go ahead and check the process ID. That means we need to first get the process ID for our payload that's running so that we could go ahead and migrate. So let's go ahead and check what's the command prompt for checking all the processes that's running. So let's check. Okay, search, upload, networking commands, git proxy, netstat, and ifconfig, ipconfig, port forward, route. No, we don't want any of these things. We just, okay, get PID, and yes, that's what we are looking for. So let's go ahead and check. Get PID 3880. That's the PID of our current session. Let's check what we get over here. And the payload. So properties. We want to check the PID for each one. Let's go ahead and check. So we have all of these things, get desktop, idle time, that's not what we're interested in. Shell, get UID of the server is running, no. Okay, PS, so we will go ahead and select PS and see all the processes that's running. So for payload, let's check the PID and the PPID. We are mostly interested in PID. So that would be 3880. So let's check if we could go ahead and use migrate 3880. Okay, that was an error from my end. What I did, I needed to migrate to explorer.exe, that is 3268. So I'll type migrate and I'll type 3268 and I'll hit enter. Let's see if we are able to migrate to the explorer.exe. Perfect. So what I did over here is that I went ahead and transferred myself to the explorer.exe. So as you can see, we do not have any payload running over here. It's only the explorer.exe. And the reason because I merged the payload along with explorer.exe, and now the person, only if he goes ahead and tries to end the process of explorer.exe, only then he will be able to go ahead and create. And as you can see, even if he deletes the payload.exe, it doesn't matter to us because we still have our meterpreter running even after that, even after the person deleted the payload. The reason being that we have migrated our payload to explorer.exe and he cannot go ahead and throw us out anytime sooner. So now once we have migrated, we need to make sure that even if the person goes ahead and restarts his computer, we would still be able to go ahead and run our system. So there are two different ways for that. The first thing is that we go ahead and copy this payload to a startup folder over here and make it run every time. And the second one is that we create a virus so that it runs every time the system starts. It starts with the boot sector. So the thing that I would be teaching you right now is to go ahead and copy this to our startup file. So we have this payload over here in the user share set, and we need to copy it to our, let's say, so it's under Microsoft roaming Windows, never mind wherever it is. So I have the location of that. It doesn't mind where it is exactly. So I need to copy that over here so that it will run every time I go ahead and run this.